imagine if you could go from looking at pictures on a display screen to just having insights delivered in a tabular format. What Earth AI enables is a way to look at all change that really helps companies like Planet distill the insight that you need and give customers what they want in a matter of minutes.
By querying imagery, we can actually answer questions the same way we type on a very simple search, but doing that on imagery and having information extracted from not just a single piece of imagery, but essentially entire library of imagery.
I'm Kritika. I lead the spacecraft and the AI research teams at Planet, and we work on building and launching lots and lots of satellites to capture images of the whole planet every day and build solutions and applications on top of our data to serve our customers.
My name is Nicolas Tussi. I'm a managing director of the geospatial business at Airbus in North America. Every day we have a suite and constellation of satellites that we're operating, collecting millions and millions of square kilometers of imagery every day. That's a lot of data on a global basis, and there's just no way we can harness information out of that product by just processing and having human looking at it. So AI is an essential part of the business where we running Earth AI through our system to really extract insight, information of the product.
We have a vision of the whole planet, but making sense of what has changed through traditional means was very difficult because you're combing through so much data and the systems were not built up to enable that. Earth AI was trained on so much labeled data. There's a lot more nuanced understanding of the context. So when we switched to text-based searches, Earth AI really stood out.
AI really allows us to change the way we actually interact with the data entirely. We are able to essentially extract features from the imagery, very different type of feature. It could be buildings, it could be vectors, it could be roads, and doing that at various resolution in a very, very large scale. You can essentially rebuild a 2D, a 3D environment from those extraction. We all have seen a lot of examples of very standard use of AI. We can now take that further, semantic-based natural language on data, on imagery. By doing this, what we are able is essentially to simply query imagery.
We monitor the whole world every day. One day's worth of the whole world is 30 terabytes of imagery. With AI, we are able to create embeddings with various foundation models. With embeddings, we can now store these embeddings in tabular data, like BigQuery, and then it becomes seconds to extract the insights that we want from BigQuery.
When you come and process data from millions of square kilometers, what would usually take you weeks of processing, you can really do that in a matter of hours. You're bringing solution to your customer that is near real time, not just to very technical team, but really to the decision maker directly.
When you deal with a large volume of data, latency becomes extremely critical, and tools like BigQuery are enabling us to get to value faster. We launch satellites to space to understand what is going on here on the Earth. We can look back in time to see what has changed to help our customers understand whether their property is getting built the way they want or whether their farmlands are yielding the production that they need. We see that in our imagery, and as soon as you see that line in a densely canopied region, you know trees on both sides are going to get cleared. You need to really see what is changing for you to fix it before it's too late. You know, that's what inspires me to come to work every day.
We build this model, and what we really want is essentially to extract insight out of it, making sure that those products are part of a decision tool we can bring to customer solution. We have a lot of application, for instance, related to vegetation management. How can you actually extract vegetation encroachment on various features on the ground? It could be pipeline, it could be trickle power grid, and so on and so forth. We have a very unique opportunity to work with Google and try to really develop very foundational solution for our business.
What we are very hopeful for in the next couple of years is the possibility of building out a queryable Earth vision. We are at the very cusp of enabling it because of where AI has taken us over the last several years and because of companies like Google investing in foundation models that are critical to companies like Planet. It's an exciting time to be working on problems. We all talk about AI as making life easy, improving productivity, but there is a an element of AI where it can actually help solve problems and help our planet. And we should try to use AI for all those purposes too.
Thank you.